Good afternoon, I'm Miranda Kahn. We start in New York, where a SkyWest plane just made an emergency landing. The FAA says a cabin door opened, causing rapid loss in air pressure. There are reports some passengers even passed out, but according to NBC, SkyWest says that never happened. It says the plane made an emergency landing because a passenger became ill and passed out. Another day of gut-wrenching testimony during the penalty phase of the Boston Marathon bombing trial. Jurors were moved to tears as they heard from the brother and stepfather of Sean Collier. He was the MIT police officer who Tsarnaev's older brother shot to death after the attack. Collier's stepfather told jurors that Sean's mother was so devastated she couldn't even get out of bed for months. In France, an Algerian man is behind bars after exposing his plot to attack churches by accident. Prosecutors say officers arrested the 24-year-old computer science student Sunday. He apparently shot himself by accident and called an ambulance. When police arrived, they found a mini arsenal of guns and ammunition. France continues being on heightened security alert since January. That's when the terror attacks on Charlie Hebdo magazine and a Jewish supermarket prompted that alert. Back here in the U.S., there's an outbreak in Ohio. One woman is dead. 23 others are sick after attending a church potluck dinner in Lancaster. The culprit? Botulism.
In this type of an event, canned foods that are improperly canned are highly suspect, and we are working on narrowing down the exact food that was identified, but we have not identified the exact food.
Botulism is not contagious unless you eat contaminated food. If you think dealing with the IRS is taxing, you're not alone. A new report from House Republicans finds the IRS phone system hung up on more than 8 million taxpayers. And for those not disconnected, well, only 40% talk to an actual human being. The IRS chief blames it on budget cuts. There's a spring thaw in the housing market. Home sales surged more than 6% last month to their highest level in a year and a half. The largest gains came from the Northeast and the Midwest. Ben Affleck is now apologizing for trying to do what some call hiding from the past. On Facebook, the actor says he was embarrassed when he found out one of his ancestors was a slave owner. The revelation came during the production of the PBS show Finding Your Roots. Affleck lobbied to have that left out, according to some reports, and eventually it was. The whole incident came to light this week as part of the Sony email hack. That was your very latest Newsmax Now update, and we'll have more coming your way in 30 minutes.